A fast attack craft, FAC, is a small, fast, agile and offensive warship armed with anti-ship missiles, gun or torpedoes. FACs are usually operated in close proximity to land, as they lack both the sea-keeping and all-round defensive capabilities to survive in blue water. The size of the vessel also limits the fuel, stores and water supplies. In size they are usually between 50 to 800 tons, and can reach speeds of 25 to 50 knots. A fast attack craft's main advantage over other warship types is its affordability. Many FACs can be deployed at relatively low cost, allowing a navy which is at a disadvantage to effectively defend itself against the larger adversary. A small boat, when equipped with the same weapons as its larger counterpart, can pose a serious threat to even the largest of capital ships. Their major disadvantages are poor seagoing qualities, cramped quarters and poor defense against aerial threats. A missile boat or missile cutter is a small, fast warship armed with anti-ship missiles. Being smaller than other warships such as destroyers and frigates, missile boats are popular, with nations interested in forming a navy at lower cost. They are similar in concept to the torpedo boats of World War II. In fact, the first missile boats were modified torpedo boats, with the torpedo tubes replaced by missile tubes. The doctrine behind the use of missile boats is based on the principle of mobility over defense and firepower. The advent of proper guided missile and electronic countermeasure technologies gave birth to the idea that warships could now be designed to outmaneuver their enemies and conceal themselves while carrying powerful weapons. Previously, increasing the potency of naval artillery required larger projectiles, which require larger and heavier guns, which in turn called for larger ships to carry these guns and their ammunition and absorb the recoil. This trend culminated in the giant battleships of World War II. The ability to deploy anti-ship guided self-propelled warheads from small, maneuverable platforms partially negated the advantages provided by the earlier and larger warships. Missile boats, when equipped with sophisticated anti-ship missiles, and especially when used in a swarm, can pose a significant threat to even the largest of capital ships, and do so at much greater ranges than is possible with torpedoes. Indonesia also does not want to be left behind by creating warships as mentioned above, namely the Clurit class fast attack craft, are a class of domestically designed and built warships operated by the Indonesian Navy. Vessels of this class are named after indigenous weapons and swords used in Indonesia. The Clurit was built by PT Palindo Marine Industries, Tanjunguncang, Batam. PT Palindo also worked with Daewoo Shipbuilding and Marine Engineering's Daesun Shipyard in South Korea on the design and construction of four Makassar-class landing platform docks. The Clurit is named after a curved blade weapon native to the Madurese people of East Java. Another ship with the same specifications was commissioned by the Indonesian Navy in February 2012, named KRI Kujang 642. Two more had been commissioned by the end of 2013, with the total of 9 planned by the end of 2014. Three of the new vessels are being constructed by PT Palindo, with nearby PT Citra working on the fourth. The Clurit prioritizes the element of surprise, rapid strike, destroying multiple targets at once and avoidance. She has a crew of 35. The first four of the class were originally armed with just a Dino Vector 20mm cannon and two 12.7mm machine guns. In May 2014 the Clurit and Kujang were fitted with a Chinese-made 6-barreled MG18 30mm six and two of the new C705 SSM, although Jane states that they can each carry four such missiles. Indonesia hopes to license build the C705, which is a derivative of the Chinese C704 anti-shipping missile, with a turbojet to extend the range to 120 kilometers, 65 nautical miles. Although the first C705 have been fitted, it is not clear when they will become operational. The Indonesian Navy at this time has received and delivered 8 units of these warships, among others. K. KRI Clurit, 641, is a Clurit-class fast attack craft of the Indonesian Navy. She was commissioned in 2011, and was the lead ship in her class. Clurit has a displacement of 250 tons, a length of 43 meters, and a draft of 7.4 meters. She is equipped with C-705 missiles launchers, a 30mm gun, and two 20mm guns, alongside AK-630M6. Clurit was built by PT Palindo Marine based in Batam, as part of an order for four similar ships. She contained around 45% locally manufactured parts, and costed around $8 million. She was commissioned on April 25, 2011, by Minister of Defense Purnomo Yastjantoro, and she was assigned to the Western Fleet Command, Cormabar. In July 2015, Clurit seized two Vietnamese fishing vessels off Ranai, Natuna. She rescued 15 fishermen from their burning vessel in 2017 off Sabang. KRI Kujang, 642, is a Clurit-class fast attack craft of the Indonesian Navy. The vessel has a length of 44 meters, a draft of 7.4 meters, and a maximum speed of 30 knots. She has a crew complement of 35, and is equipped with C-705 missiles, a 20mm Dino Vector GI-2 main gun, and was later fitted with the AK-636. Kujang was built by PT Palindo Marine based in Batam, as part of an order for four similar ships. She contained around 45% locally manufactured parts, and costed around $8 million. She was commissioned on February 16, 2012, as the second ship of her class, after Clurit, and was assigned to the Western Fleet Command, Cormabar. KRI Balabay, 643, is a Clurit-class fast attack craft of the Indonesian Navy. Commissioned in 2013, she is the third ship of her class. The vessel has a length of 44 meters, a draft of 7.4 meters, and a displacement of 250 tons, with the maximum speed of 27 knots. She has a crew complement of 35, and is equipped with C-705 missiles, a 20mm Dino Vector GI-2 main gun, and was later fitted with the AK-636. Balabay was commissioned by Minister of Defense Purnomo Yastjantoro in Batam on January 25, 2013. She is part of the Indonesian Navy's Western Fleet Command, Cormabar. KRI Alamang, 644, is a Clurit-class fast attack craft of the Indonesian Navy. Commissioned in 2013, she is the fourth ship of her class. The vessel has a length of 44 meters, a draft of 8 meters, and a displacement of 238 tons, with the maximum speed of 27 knots. She has a crew complement of 35, and is equipped with two Chinese-made C-705 missile launchers, a 30mm main gun, and two 20mm Dino Vector GI-2 guns. The ship costed ₹73.6 million in 2013. Alamang was commissioned by Minister of Defense Purnomo Yastjantoro in Batam on December 20, 2013. Alongside two patrol boats also built by Palindo. She is part of the Indonesian Navy's Western Fleet Command, Cormabar. In the Western Fleet Command, she patrolled the waters around Batam and the Singapore Strait, capturing vessels without documentation or smugglers. She also patrols the waters around the Natuna Islands, capturing one Vietnamese fishing vessel there in 2017. And on September 27, 2014, the Indonesian Navy received four Clurit-class fast attack craft from the company PT Citra, Batam, Indonesia, namely KRI Surik, 645. The Surik is a traditional sword of the island of Timor. The first coat of arms of East Timor depicted crossed Suriks. KRI Sawaer, 646. Sawaer, a traditional knife. KRI Perang, 647, the Perang is a type of knife used across the Malay archipelago. KRI Terapang, 648, Terapang, a crease made of precious metals such as gold or silver.